So today let's take a look at some cheap Chinese crash cams. And those are car black boxes or dash cams or dashboard cameras, car DVRs or onboard cameras. But I call them crash cams because the point of them basically is to record it when you crash. You have this camera in your car constantly recording, and if somebody crashes you or causes an accident, it's good to have an evidence. The video can prove it wasn't your fault, or it can also help you in case of an insurance fraud. Those can also help you in case of police corruption or vandalism, but on the other hand, they are completely illegal in some countries, and in other countries they may be illegal under some conditions. Such camera is constantly recording video in a loop, and in case of crash, you can also use it as a still camera to make more evidence. But it has no internet connection, so you can't share it directly on Facebook. This one was just for $7 and this one for $8. Now let's take a closer look at them. So this is camera number one. It comes in a plastic bag. It contains a car charger, this suction cup to mount it on a windscreen or windshield. There is a USB cable to transfer the data into your computer. And this is the camera in a protective bag. So let's take a look at it. It has a display, one button here. Other 5 or 6 or more buttons here. Power, two arrows. Menu, OK, mode, and this is probably a reset button. And here you can see the lens. And there are 6 infrared LEDs for night vision. This is probably the speaker. And this is the connector for charging or data transfer. So let's try to turn it on. Blue LED comes on. Earth is here. It's the other way around. Well, and it says no card, because I have to put a memory card in it here. It doesn't have internal memory. So let's put a memory card in it. And I can see now it started recording actually. The power button can also switch day or night vision. Oh, battery low. So let's try to charge it because the battery is empty. And let's measure the current as well. Now it should be charging 0.14 amps. It's enough given how small the battery probably is. It shows date, time, and this is probably how much video recording is remaining. You can record 2.5 hours of video. That's a lot. Here you can switch day or night. And here you can see those infrared LEDs. But it's probably useless because everything you are recording is probably too far from you anyway. But it says it can record 1080p full HD video. Okay, there is a mode button. You can also take still pictures. Or you can record sound only. And this is the playback mode. Back to video. I will press menu. And there is some setting. You can set size of the video. You can choose Full HD, HD or VGA. Timestamp on, motion detect. Video time, not sure what it is. Voice record. Format. This is going to format your card. I don't want this. Languages. Automatic off. System reset. Light frequency. You can set 50 or 60 Hz to prevent flicker. That's clever. Date input. Here you are probably setting date. USB. Not sure what it is. Version view. Okay, that's about it. Let's switch it to still camera and now I've probably made a still picture and another accidentally. Let's open menu and it's very simple. You can only set the size 3 megapixels to 1.3 or VGA. This is the size of the still pictures. And there is another menu, but this one is the same as in the camera mode. And this mode is audio only. Not very interesting. And this is playback. Okay. Video recording. I will press OK and now it's recording. Here the time is running. It's in day mode. And full HD resolution probably. It looks nice. There is some button which seems to do nothing. But anyway, it looks nice. Now there's time to record some videos and show you the results. Well, the quality doesn't really meet my expectations. The listing says it can record full HD, but it actually records just VGA. And this is regardless of the setting in menu. In the menu you can set full HD, HD or VGA, but in reality it's always VGA. Now what about the viewing angle? The lens of the camera is here and I can see my pen in the display from here to about here. So the horizontal angle is going to be about 32 degrees I have measured. And the diagonal angle is the horizontal angle times 0.25 and this is 40 degrees. So the angle in the listing is a little bit far from reality actually. Now regarding the sound recording, the listing only says it has sound. So let's test it. Now I'm trying to talk so that you can hear the quality of the sound and you can also see my cat. So as you can see it does have a sound, but not the best quality one. Now what about the battery life? The listing says built-in battery supports long time recording. But in reality the battery can last 2 minutes 40 seconds on a full charge. After this time it dies. Are you kidding me guys? So the only way you can really use it is using this car charger connected all the time. Now testing the night vision in the dark and I can't see anything. Even with the infrared LEDs on. And now I can barely see my cat from less than half a meter.
Now I can see her. So this is the night vision.
So as you can see, there is a night vision, but with about half a meter range. So you basically can't even see your hood. This must be a joke. This one seems to have a video locking button or a saving button, because normally it's recording in a loop. If it runs out of memory, it will delete the old files. But if you want to keep some video, you press this one and it will lock it so it doesn't get deleted. It seems to be saving the files every 3 minutes. Now it saves the file and it begins another file. Here you can actually set the looping interval. 1, 3, 5, or 10 minutes. It also claims to have a G sensor, so it will automatically save the video if you crash. Let's test it. It doesn't seem so. There is probably no G sensor in it. No, it didn't log the video. I can only lock it manually. Now you can see the lock. No, there is no G sensor in it. Now let's take a look at the other camera. Just very quickly, because it's very similar. There is a suction cup for mounting. The camera, some manual. And a car charger. There is actually no USB connector, so how do I connect it to my PC? I don't know. And this is just charging cable. And this is the suction cup. Okay. The camera is here. And it has about the same lens. A speaker, a microphone, a reset button here. Probably it gets stuck very often, so you have to reset it. There is a power button. Blue LED comes on. You can see the earth again. So it seems to have similar software in it. It says no card, so wait. So let's put a 16 gigabyte card into it again. Now it should work. And there is a video mode, still picture mode, and playback mode. There is the power button. This is the menu, which is very, very similar. You can set the resolution somewhat, but in reality, the resolution is always just VGA, no matter what you set. And the battery is low. So let's charge it. I have to use my own cable because there is no USB cable in it. Okay. This one switches some illumination, even though there are no infrared LEDs in it. That's weird. And the display is kind of loose inside. That's interesting. Now let's test the video quality and sound quality. Now testing the sound quality. Can you hear me? And this is my cat again. So this camera is almost the same as the other one. The resolution always is just VGA or 480p. The angle is also the same. The sound is maybe even a little bit shittier. The battery also lasts maybe 1 or 2 minutes, and there is no night vision. So this camera is similar to the other one, but on the top of it, it's missing the USB cable. The sound is even worse, and this one doesn't seem to have the saving button. So to sum it up, those cameras are working, but the resolution is not very high, only 480p. The angle is not very high, and this may be a little bit problem in this application. The sound is very poor, but this is not that much important here. The battery is very shitty, so you always use it just with the chargers. You can't use it on battery. The infrared vision is completely useless, but on the other hand, for just $7 or $8, it's not so bad. And this one actually is a little bit better, yet it's the cheaper one. And maybe I'm going to make a teardown of those cameras and those chargers in another video. So this is Diagon Wild, and see you in my next videos.